Another life-saving incident occurred earlier in 1970 when I was still district senior advisor in Duc Tan district in Sedek province in the Mekong Delta. This occurred as we were driving to a sort of celebration to welcome the new Vietnamese senior province chief. And a dinner was being held for him in a rather peaceful village called Tan Tan Village, which was right on the Mekong River. And like every other village, was filled with canals and filled with water. And the canals were quite swollen during this period because it was the rainy season. So the senior American advisor had come to pick me up, and he and I rode together in his International Harvester Scout, sort of the equivalent of an SUV, two-door vehicle that all of the advisors had. He had a Vietnamese driver who was driving it, and he was sitting in the front seat with the driver on the left side. He's on the right side, and I'm in the back seat. And we go to this dinner out in the village. It's a very nice evening, a lot of good food, and a lot of Vietnamese rice wine being served to everyone. Rice wine is sort of the equivalent of ethanol. You know, it's pure white, and it hits you like a bolt of lightning when you drink a small amount of it. So it was thought to be okay, you know, for us to indulge since we weren't driving. What we didn't know was that the drivers, including his driver, were also over there drinking more than they should of the rice wine. So the dinner ends, we get in our vehicle to leave, and we're driving on this small road and going over one after another these small little bridges, cement bridges over the canals. And we're going along at probably a pretty fast clip, no air conditioning, the windows are down in the car, and we get to a bridge, and the driver is so inebriated that he misses the middle of the bridge. He gets just the wheels on the right side of the vehicle on the bridge. The others are off. We go up on the edge. The vehicle teeters over, falls off the bridge into the middle of the canal, and sinks to the bottom as the vehicle is filling up with water. So the vehicle's now on its side. The driver is down here at the bottom. My supervisor is, his seat is kind of at the top, and I'm in the back. His window is rolled down. The only way out is out through that window. Instinctively, I start moving towards the window, and his hand, my supervisor's, the senior American senior advisor's hand hits me, and it's like a band of steel. I learned this lesson of how people react in dangerous, life-threatening situations. They get incredible power. He holds me off, gets himself out the window, and heads to the top. I start to follow him, and I look over, and there's the driver, and he's, if not unconscious, disoriented, he's inebriated, he's underwater, he's in shock, he can't move. And so I have this moment, and I go over, I grab him, I pull him with me, and up towards the window, I get myself out. We're still underwater in all of this, holding my breath. I pull him out the window with me and head up to the surface. And we get there, and there are people who have stopped and come over to the bank, and people pull him out and help pull me out. What went through my mind was this all happened just shortly after Chappaquiddick incident in 1969, where Senator Kennedy was driving a vehicle with members of the campaign staff. They went off a bridge underwater and terrible result that a young woman in the car drowned and her life was lost. And so it kind of brought to me, this was like a Chappaquiddick incident, although I was able to keep the driver from drowning and was able to extricate myself as well. One more life-saving situation and event that seemed to pop up amazingly frequently during my 2 years of service in Sadek province.